Do you have a hard time selling your product, even if it's on a discount? Like, even if you got a special, a limited time special, and you just have a difficult time selling it? Like, man, I don't get it. They won't buy it at the regular price. They won't buy it at a discount. Like, what am I doing wrong? Has that ever happened to you? Well, I want to share with you a couple sales tips that's going to help you increase your sales anytime you ever have a special going on, or if you're like me and you work in an industry that's actually determined by the market, like however the 10 years doing, that's going to be basically what your price is, right? So sometimes, well, actually oftentimes, the price will change, right? It rarely stays the same. It's either going to go up and continue going up, or it's going to go down. And sometimes, and you know, at least in my line of work, sometimes that's what you rely on to create urgency, right? It's like, oh, the market's gonna change, the market's gonna change, it's gonna get worse, right? You kind of sell on the notion of fear, the fear of missing out, that FOMO strategy, right? And so I wanna share with you something that I've noticed a lot of salesmen do, and I think it could be just switched. If you learn how to look at it a little bit differently, you can actually look at it as an opportunity to leverage the instance, right? Because it's not all the time that you're going to get a discount. It's not all the time that you're going to get an improved market. Sometimes you're going to get a worse market. Sometimes your product's just going to, you know, go back to its retail price. And so the question is, well, how do I leverage this opportunity? How do I leverage this time? And to answer that question, before I do, you know, let me confirm with you, you're going to want to watch the video the whole way through. A lot of times, you know, a lot of these videos, I got to say, I mean, the first maybe 3 or 5 minutes I'm warming up, and I typically warm up with sharing with you a story that I personally have gone through, or I've seen and witnessed myself. And through that story, I hope to, you know, kind of paint the picture for you so that you could relate and say, oh yeah, now I get it. Okay, cool. I want to know how to overcome that. And a lot of the gold nuggets is actually put out towards the end of the video. And I want to share with you that, you know, in the very beginning of the videos, or sometimes in the middle or the end, whenever or however you do watch it, my only request from you, because you see that I don't charge for this, coach. I don't ask you for any money for this. I do it absolutely for free. And my goal is to share with you a resource that I wish I had coming up, because if I would have had this resource, or if I would have had this advice, I would have shed years off of hitting that six-figure income. I would have shed years off of becoming a homeowner. I would have shed years off of getting the very things that I want. And more importantly, I would have saved years of time just wasting time. Wasting time, you know, wondering why I'm not good enough, or wasting time studying the wrong people, studying the wrong habits, doing the wrong moves. And so here, you're gonna be able to filter out all that noise and just come across the content and the information that really does work. If you look at the reviews on my Instagram channel, which I'll leave a link below this video, and you go to the profile page, there's highlights. You know, you wanna follow the page so that you can see the highlights. But one of the highlights is called reviews. And so you get to read through the reviews. If you go to my website, you're going to be able to see comments, and those are actual people. You can actually reference all the reviews on the Facebook page. Again, I'll leave a link below this video. I'll leave a link across all my channels on the video. And more importantly, there's a link below for the sales script. You know, I get hit up a lot from a lot of the audience members saying, hey man, I can't find the script, where's the script? And there's been a link underneath every video that I post sharing with you this free sales script. So if you haven't downloaded the sales script, or if you wonder how come, you know, you signed up for it, you're not getting it, it's because you're probably using your work email and you need to use a personal email. And even if you use your personal email and you do request one, look in your junk or your spam folder, because it's coming from salesremaster.com, and I might have very well been quarantined and shot over to that folder. But get a gander, because the information is for free, and all that I ask for you is that you comment, like, and subscribe. You know, you maybe timestamp the section of the video that you appreciate most and share with the community what you took away from it. And so in this video, my goal is to help the salespeople understand how to never let an opportunity like a limited time sale or an improvement in the market slip by them. Because I think that too often times salesmen will, you know, like I'm going to use my environment as an example. You know, sometimes when we come in the day, the market might open in a better state than it was the day before. So we'll get what's called a rate sheet. And this rate sheet will say, you know, markets improved by like a quarter, or sometimes markets improved by like 50 basis points, which is 0.5%. And this is pretty big, right? Because sometimes depending on the loan amount, that can mean thousands of dollars in lender credit. It can mean an 0.8% to 0.25% lower in interest rate. And those are mainly the two things that really determine your consumer or your prospect's interest, is the rate and fees. And sometimes that's ultimately what actually stops them from proceeding, is because they don't agree with the rate and fees, or they're in constant search of the lowest rate and lowest fees. Who isn't, right? And so when these instances happen where we come into the you know, the sales floor, and then one of the very first emails we get is where the market's at, because the market opens up, you know, and then it lets you know how the market is. And sometimes we'll get these notices, maybe the market's bad, maybe it's worse, or you know, maybe it's improved. And so in the times where it's improved, I've noticed a lot of salesmen, and you can use this example to your own industry. Maybe you might work at Verizon and you guys have a special on the new iPhone, right? And you want to know, how do you announce it, right? How do you attract attention towards it? Well, when it happens inside my industry, what I've noticed is that a lot of salesmen will call their prospects and say, "Hey, Mr. Johnson, this is Daniel with New American Funding. Hey, I the market actually improved today. I want to see if you're still in the market to refinance, or to get some cash out, or to do, you know, another call so we can review any questions that you guys have. Hey, the market improved. I want to let you know that your lender credit can be increased, or your rate can drop. Or, hey, you know what, the market improved. I want to know if we can maybe schedule a call where we could talk about the figures again." And the problem with that is, though, is that sometimes we forget that what we're telling the prospect is, hey, the market improved, which makes it very general, right? And so if the market improved for you, then I know the market improved for your competitor and your competitor's competitor. And so sometimes we don't realize that what we're telling our prospect is that, hey, the price just lowered for everyone that you talk to. So anyone you talk to, got a quote from, or got, you know, a estimate from, all of it can be improved. And the problem with that is that we're not attaching any exclusivity to it, meaning we're not making it, you know, something that we can give. And so what I have found to be more efficient through my own experience is that when you notice a market improvement, when you notice maybe a discount coming up, right? You might have a sale coming up, or you might got a special in this particular program. Instead of saying, "Hey, the market's improved," what you should do is probably call them and say, "Hey, you know what, I got an idea. I'm doing a large volume of business within your area, or I'm helping a large volume of homeowners in your area, and I'm doing a very successful campaign, and I'm selecting 4 other homeowners who I can present to my manager as kind of like a blanket discount, meaning that in your particular county, my brand, my name has become so widely known that I've shared with my manager that my goal is to network throughout your entire county. So I'm working with a lot of homeowners within your area and I'm taking care of them. What I've done is I basically assisted them with achieving their financial goal and helping them obtain their goal much faster through a specific proven plan. And so what my goal is to include you into this batch and ask for the exception to apply to all of the clients that I'm working with in that area. So I got an idea. I want to run it by you first just to make sure. Here's what it looks like. Basically, what I'm doing is I'm going to ask for an exception to get you the same exact benefit and discount that I'm getting these other homeowners within your area, within your community. And if I'm successful, what I'm able to do is do X, Y, and Z. And whatever that X, Y, and Z is basically just the result of the improved market. And so if that improved market increases your, let's say, lender credits by $1,000, just say, "Hey, you know, if I can get my manager to accept it, I can, you know, I know I quoted you about a month ago $500 in lender credit. I'm prepared to ask for $1,500 in lender credit." That's massive. It's huge. It's half the closing cost. But here's the thing, is that I can only fit maybe 3 or 4 people in when I ask for that exception. I want to know if you want to be one of them. And so what you're doing is you're basically making it exclusive. You're making it more relevant to their community because they believe a lot of their home, the neighborhood, is doing it. And more importantly, you're using the FOMO effect, but you're using it more effectively. And so instead of saying, you know, hey, the market's improved. Hey, price has gone down on these Verizon products. Or hey, you know, there's a $500 sale or the 50% off sale. You know, the more effective way is saying, hey, man, I want to hook you up. Check this out. I know a guy who knows a guy. Get it? You ever hear that? Like, hey, man, you got to go talk to my buddy. Right? Like that's a hookup. And so when you have someone feeling like they're individually hooked up, like you got the plug, you got the connect, it takes it away from being just like, hey, man, market's good, because then you leave yourself in prone to other rebuttals or other objections. Like, well, we'll see if tomorrow the market improves again, or we'll see. Well, if the market improved for you, then it's got to improve for them. Let me go and see what they got, because they had a lower price than you to begin with. So if you're lower, let me see how lower they get. Right? There's just so many different variables. But if you say, hey, me, I'm doing a specific campaign and I want to help you, then it just seems like there's this individual relationship and kind of this bond where oh man, this dude's got the hookup. Let me go. You know, you're building the curiosity, you're building that FOMO effect, you're building that exclusivity that I believe you need and you need to focus on, rather than saying, hey, the market in general has just improved, let's go ahead and look at it again. So I hope that helps, and leave your comment below. Let me know what your takeaway is. Let me know if you can implement this strategy in today's business so that you can improve your week and pick up yourself a couple extra sales. How much are those extra sales worth to you? How much extra would you earn if you knew that you can double your sales every week? So if you earn 3 sales, what if I helped you make it 6? If you make 6 sales every week, what if I helped you make it 12? And then if you close 30 loans a month, what if I helped you turn that into 60? What would that do to your life? What would it do to your surroundings? What would it do to your quality, your bank account, your experience, your car, your clothes, your family, everything, right? Like, everything would just naturally improve. And my goal is to help you improve and help you remaster your ability to understand sales, marketing, and influence. And I hope I've done that. So please consider subscribing, leave a comment, timestamp your favorite section of this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Talk and get to it. Hard liquor here. Rip hard, really do it. Hard liquor here. We can buy the boy all night.